Hey, what's up? It's me, Chemical Engineering Guy, and in this video we're going to see a review of the book of Basic Principles and Calculations in Chemical Engineering by the author David Himmelblau. Typical energy balance book, or at least I've seen that many people use it for energy balance. The book is divided in 5 parts, and one part is for material balances. Or mass balances. So I didn't know that before. I studied mass balance and didn't have enough information or data, and then I got to my energy balance course and saw this book that had this part especially designed for mass balance. It's one of my favorites. It's very well designed. How do you see it in order? How do they explain you everything? All that. It's very, very cool. I love it. One of my definitely top 3 of all the chemical engineering books. I think they explain very, very good the material balance part. I will actually recommend that. You can buy it before you get to the energy balance course. So you're studying mass balance and you want to get that book, I totally recommend it. So the first thing you're going to get are the index. And you will see that it has a lot of chapters. I think I like this way of ordering the chapters better, because if I open the book and I want to see, I don't know, there's many explicit material, for example, multiple mass balance or multiple units mass balancing, I can see it in the index. Whereas in the Felder book, I don't know how, I just need to book, check all the pages and finally stumble and check, oh, here's speaking about multiple units. And here you can find it in the index, which I think is very, very good. There's a chapter for recycle, bypass and purge, chemical reaction of one single unit. You have a lot of very specific chapters. Part one is essentially the introduction. You're going to find some dimensions, units. They're going to speak about moles. Chapter 2, you see concentration, all that. Then chapter 3, basis of calculations. Then you get chapter 4, how to choose a basis of calculation. That's, as I told you before, that's very, very, like, there's a chapter for that in Himmelblau. I love it. And Felder, they just comment you that you should get a basis of calculation. Even though it's the same content, I love that here they design specifically a chapter for that. So that's why I like it better. Chapter 4 is about temperature, how to distinguish temperature, all the scales, absolute temperatures, Fahrenheit, Rankine, Celsius, Kelvin. Then chapter 5 is about pressure, also absolute pressure, manometric pressure, atmospheric pressure, all those, and PSI, atmosphere, bars, how to measure pressure, etc. Then it comes part number 2, which is chapter 6 to chapter 12. All the material balance part, you got the introduction to mass balance, how do you use it, when do you use it, how do you do it. Then you jump to chapter 7, method or general methodology to solve it. So maybe you remember that in the Felder course, in the Felder book, sorry, you have this methodology. It's actually very similar, but the thing here is you need to find it in the book. You need to search for pages, and you have here a chapter that says, go there, strategy to find and solve problems in material balances. So I love that part. Just go read it and you're done with the chapter. Comes chapter 8, which is a single unit mass balance. Only one unit, inlet, outlet. Then you master that and then you should go to chapter 9, with the chemical concept or the reaction concept, production, consumption, stoichiometry, mass balances, equations, all that, the balancing equations, all those stuff are in this chapter. And then you go to chapter 10, once you've got this mass balance concept. So that's also cool, you have a chapter for that. And in Felder you do not have that. You have the material, but you don't have it in a chapter. So that's, once again, that's cool to have a chapter speaking about one topic. Chapter 11 is about mass balances in multiple units. So eventually, you know, a chemical plant is full of unit operations. It's not only one. You have one reactor, then one pump, one dryer, and then one separator, a distillation, you recycle. You have a lot of equipment, so eventually you need to find out how to calculate mass balances in those processes. Then chapter 12, recycle, bypass and purge. part three, which is ideal gases, real gases, liquids and solid, equilibrium, solid, liquid, liquid, vapor. Everything is in the Himmelblau part in part three. So you have ideal gas, one chapter for that, which is cool. You got one chapter for real gas using compressibility factor, the C chart. You remember that? Then we have another chapter about equation of states. We got another chapter, one condensable vapor pressure and all that systems. Then you got one chapter, which is chapter 17, about saturation, humidity, all that. And once again, I know I'm always telling you, but having it in different chapters, it's very good to understand and to structure yourself and get how the course is, how is the structure of the course, because once you get that, you can actually start joining ideas, knowing why you saw that before, and then this stuff here. Then we go to chapter 18, which is also about humidity, the chart, a little bit saturation, to chapter 19 about the phase rule, Gibbs phase rule, or when a system is set, if you have pressure, temperature, composition. Chapter 20, which is liquid and gases and their interaction with solids. So we go with part 4, which is energy balances. I know this review is specifically for the mass balance course, but if you are interested in doing energy balances, it's also a great book to learn that. You can do it in the Feller book. I think it's not that normal. Normally you got Feller book for material balances and you get the Himmelblau book for energy balances. So I would recommend using this for your energy balance course. Part 5, which is the last part, finally, it's chapter 30, which is how to do a degree of analysis in steady state problems. It's cool. Actually, I will recommend it a lot if you can do it. Read it. It will save you time in the long term. Maybe in the at first it's not going, you're going to see, why do I do this? It's better just go and start doing the problem. But once you're getting better and better, and once you're getting more complex problems, you're going to start to understand why you should do that. So read that part if you want. You don't need to, but I strongly recommend it. Then chapter 31, it's about software solving, how to use software in problems and chemical processes. Chapter 32 is about transient state and energy balance. Recommend it if you have the CD, because this is in the CD. You don't have it like physical in the book. You need to have the CD. If you have it, read it. Why not? It's cool. You always need transient state in many, many processes in real life. So get used to that. You got a list, a huge amount of appendixes, actually from letter A to letter N, I think it's about 20 something appendixes. Use them, they're cool. You have many, many data that you're going to use, not only in your class, in this class, and not only in your course. Maybe when you work, you're going to use it. You're going to remember, where do I get this constant? And you will be like, oh yeah, I remember in the book, I got this. It's very valuable. I think it's one of the best appendixes of all the books in chemical engineering. If you ask me, should I buy this book? Yes, buy it. It's totally worth it. Actually, you enjoy it. If you like chemical engineering, you are enjoying how you read it. It's easy to read. You understand fast, very well structured. Yeah, if you can study mass balance there, also do it. Energy balance is a must. And yeah, you're going to get the introduction to the energy concept. So for thermodynamics, you can also start getting a little bit of information before you go to your thermodynamics course. So that was everything, guys. We've seen a small overview review of the book. I think it's a good book. So thank you for watching and keep watching reviews. You like, or you want me to recommend you a book, just tell me, hit me an email. There's an email section here, and see you guys. What's up, guys? It's me, Chemical Engineering Guy. So if you like the video, why not push the like button?
It really helps me to know if you're liking the videos or if I should be changing something or I should be adding something, taking out content, whatever. Also, sharing is caring. So if you got any kind of friends, teachers, colleagues, or whatever kind of person that might be interested in this type of content, why not share it? Sharing helps our community to grow faster in members and in content. If you want to keep track of my activity, videos, uploads, experiments, playlists, whatever content I'm getting on YouTube, be sure to click the subscribe button. Subscribing to the channel is totally free, guys. My dream is to create an online academy of chemical engineering, where everyone can access it in the world. Imagine a place in which the student, the teacher, and the engineer get the best of each other. So thank you, guys, for the support and the love.